Welcome to my projectbazaar.com. Now let me see about SAR image despectling based on non-subsampled shear layer transform. Now let's see about the abstract. Here we proposed a novel method to reduce the noise from the image. Initially we had to generate the Gaussian noise to the input image. To remove the noise, we use the shear layer transform. Shear layer are a multi-scale framework which allows to efficiently encoding anisotropic features in multivariate problem classes. The shear layer transform is unlike the traditional wavelet transform, which does not possess the ability to detect directionality. After that, we apply this shrinkage function. Shrinkage is also called a thresholding. Here we predict the noise thresholding in a shear layer coefficient. After that, it will be removed from the coefficient. After shrinking function, it is passed to the inverse transform to reconstruct the image. In that image, we calculate the MSE PSNR value for the analysis. After shear layer denoising, it passed to the GMAP filter to increase the image quality. This is the flow of the process. Here we have to given the image as an input. The input will pass to the noise generation. In noise generation, we generate the Gaussian noise to the image. Gaussian noise is a statistical noise that has its probability density function equal to that of the normal distribution, which is also known as the Gaussian distribution. In other words, the values of the noise can take on our Gaussian distributed. A special case is white noise, in which values any pair of times are identically distributed and statistically independent. So after generating this Gaussian noise, it will pass to the shear layer transform. The shear layer transform represents stands out since it offers a unique combination of some highly desirable properties. It has a single or finite set of generating functions. It provides optimally sparse representation for a large class of multidimensional data. It is possible to use compactly supported analyzing function. It has fast algorithmic implementation, and it allows a unified treatment of the continuum and the digital realm. After the shear layer transform, it will go to the shrinkage function. Shrinkage function is the denoising method based on the thresholding technique. Shrinkage is a signal denoising technique based on the idea of thresholding the shear layer coefficient. It is the image data gives rise to sparse coefficients in the transform form. Thus, denoising can be achieved by compressing those coefficients that compromise data's sparsity. After shrinkage, it will pass to the inverse transform. It is the reverse process of the shear layer transform. It will produce the original image. After producing the original image, it will pass to the GMAP filter. GMAP is represented as a gamma filter used preliminarily to filter speckled radar data. It is designed to smooth out the noise, white retained edges or shape features in the image. After filtering the GMAP, it passed to the result. Here we are identifying the PSNR and MSE values for the provided result. Now let's see the demo of our process. Here I am having denoise main.m file. Select this file, right click and run the file. This is our guide design. Here we have to given the input image. So initially we have to select the one image from the database. The selected image is displayed here. After that, it will go to the next step for the noise generation. Here we have to given the range. How much range have to be, and now I am giving us a range as 10. So based on this range, the noise will be generated to the original image. This is the generated noise in the input image. After that, here we are estimating the noise. based on the PSNR and MSC values. This is the PSNR and MSC values of the noisy image. After that, it will go to the second step. Here we are converting the image in the Shearlet coefficient. Shearlet will filter the image based on directionally. So process is going on now. So here we are getting a 4 level coefficients. This is the first level, and then this is second level, this is the third level, and this is fourth level of coefficient of Shearlet. After that, it will go to the shrinkage function. In shrinkage function, threshold will be selected based on the noise. The selected threshold values will be denoised from the coefficients. So now shrinkage is completed now. After that, it will go to the inverse Shearlet. So this is the denoised image of the noisy image. And here we are analyzing about the image. Here our MSC PSNR value is 41, and then it will go for the GMAP filter. This is the result of GMAP filter. So for the GMAP filter, we are getting MSC PSNR values. It will be higher than the inverse Shearlet transform. After that, we are showing the here we are showing the result of Shearlet denoising. It will show the better denoising result than the existing transforms such as DCT and Wavelet. Thank you.